Rude to the good, bruhs. Rude.
I can do all of it now. I can do it all now.
Come on now. Now, Mr. Clint George, welcome first and foremost to the fold. You know, 2020 inductee, welcome to the fold. How does that feel to finally be a member of the greatest fraternity of all time, Omega Psi Phi Fraternity Corporation?
I'm 80 years old, turning 80 years old in a few months, man. I've been waiting a long time to legally do that. You know, I mean, we've been jamming the song, you know, the national anthem for the dogs.
Come on now.
We've for years, and they've been tempted to, you know, induct me into it, you know. And it finally happened, man.
Yeah.
You know, with Anthony Hamilton and Ugly.
Yeah.
Man, we stepping on them. Yeah. We stepping. I got to learn the steps now. Yeah. But I'm in there now, so I got to learn all of the bylaws and everything. I'm studying like I'm in school again, brother.
I know, right? I am a member of the fraternity, as we all know, crossed in 2012. And the Atomic Dog, I'm sure when you created it, you didn't know what it was going to mean to our fraternity and then even to just the culture. I mean, when you hear that song, you automatically think of two things. Of course, the funk and George Clinton, but you also think of, man, where the Q's at? Where they coming? I know they coming from somewhere. Oh, your favorite line. Like, what's your favorite out of the song?
Oh, Atomic Dog. Why must I feel like that? Why must I take the cat? Nothing but the dog in me.
Dog in me. Dog in me.
That part right there explained how I was feeling at that moment. You know, it was chemically induced, or the lack of chemical induced. That's really what it was at. You know, I was in need, and I felt like they were dogging me out.
Right.
That's one of the side effects of, you know, mental drugs. It always feels like somebody doing something to you.
Gotcha.
And so all I could get out of it was going to the studio, and I, damn, give me a track. I'm going to do this. You know, you put yourself on the spot. And I remember the day looking at me when I realized that the track was backwards and I didn't know what key it was in, so I have to start talking. This is the story of famous dogs with a dog and chick. I'm just like trying to figure out what key this is in. So I talked to like, oh, they ain't gonna come in. So then I just started, you know, why must I feel like that?
Yeah, and you know what? I would have to agree with you. It's like I think it's a universal feeling. Like, why must I feel, you know what I'm saying? And then I think it's the ad-libs for me, you know, the futuristic dog and then all the other things. But I think the thing that catches me the most is the beat when it drops.
Oh, the beat. That's why, you know, the beat itself was so phenomenal that I didn't even really want to get in the way of the beat. So I basically was trying to stay away from getting, and then when I realized it was backwards.
Okay.
And I had started talking forward. Now we got to make this record work like this.
Yes.
We had to go put the drum back on again, straight, so you get some drums, because that other drum would go, you know that? We had one of the singles is without the drums in it.
Okay.
So it was actually like that. Okay. But it's one of those songs that produced itself.
Yeah.
You know, I'm into my thing, and you know, and I'm gonna make it work before I come out. And I'm good at that. I don't care how crazy it go. I'm gonna make it make sense some kind of way. And I had help with the musician Bernie Worrell. He wasn't even at the session when we did it, the song. But I know if I have him play, then. That ties me. It sounds like we did it intentionally.
Gotcha.
It sounds like it's arrangement. You know, we arranged it from the backwards forward.
Okay. And it came together in a way that I don't think you knew. And that song will live forever.
Yes. Yeah. I never tried to do it again.
Nah, no need.
When you don't even try nothing like that. None of it, you know, and it was like, it did itself. Yeah. Another one that did that was simple as it sounded, was Flashlight.
Okay.
We were just trying to, the Jackson 5 had to vibe for that era. So we had to get a song that just had little James Brown in there and the kind of a Jackson 5 tone in the voice. Mm-hmm. But the thing was, Bernie played the bass on a Moog.
Gotcha. Which
usually it's a bass player like Larry Graham, you know. Mm-hmm. Bernie played on a Moog and nobody had ever heard anybody play classical. Mm-hmm. And that's what he's playing, a classical line on the Moog. So it actually, all of a sudden, it's a slick James Brown song with some certain notes in that. You talking, I would never right. dance.
That made it come together just right.
Yeah.
Now, Mr. Clinton, I just want to say thank you for taking time out to give us the scoop on everything, you know, rude to the good brush. You know, I got to show you some of that good love.
Yeah, you got to show me that. I'm still learning now. I got to get my steps together. Yeah,
but you're throwing that hook up real, real good. So I see you've been learning.
You made me keep it down for so long.